a lot of good rehearsal as a team. So we're actually jumping into the knife round here. And as I finish my point, I'm just going to say that this is a big deal. This can make it really hard to hold off rushes when it comes to situations like that for these teams that aren't so rehearsed, when they don't have sort of a kind of understanding from serious amounts of experience and practice with the same players playing the same map again and again and again. Those are the kinds of openings you can find. Even just straightforward rushes can actually be very effective, even against great players, because it doesn't matter how good a player is. If he's not getting pop flash, if he's not getting covered properly, then if he's getting isolated, he's not going to be that valuable. So there's a lot of factors with teams that aren't very, very experienced together.
I mean, on this map, we see that Lemondogs will be starting off on the CT side, stronger side of Mirage, arguably. So that'll give them a little benefit or
And this is the standard metagame thing we're seeing here again. The three, they play for the retake on A, play defensively on A, play all the way back here, player in mid there, gives them a very good idea. They can deal with a very fast push into the B bomb site. It's not there. They're going to figure that out now, and they're going to play for the retake. But this is interesting from Expert Gaming. They're coming in from the B house here instead of a bigger split on the slope. But Lemondogs, they're okay. They're going to allow the site to be taken. This is fine. This is what they wanted. And let's see if they can pull off the standard retake.
That was a good shot there by Zevis. At least he took one down before the rest of the Expert team caught up to him. And Expert right now have been able to plant the bomb, and they're trying to defend the bomb site against the incoming CTs. Cobra coming up from behind here on T-Ramp, doing a good job getting the kill, and Stigwell, goodness me, getting three kills actually in the bomb site. Very, very nicely done by him. And that's the first round here for Expert Gaming.
I can just quickly show, whilst we go into this next eco, one of the reasons why this retake strategy and why this has entered the metagame, because as we saw that round, it's illustrated very well for them, despite the fact that Expert Gaming just won the duels. Lemondogs created a situation where quickly they're able to push with teammates down here. They didn't see a rush. They didn't get the quick information. They left one guy, you know, around this point to just push by himself. He could go flank all the way around here into this bomb site. That means they're getting a retake from here, and from here. So they get like a really good four-way kind of crossfires going on.
Yeah. Yep.
So that's a really good retake situation for them. That's one of the reasons why we see this as the very standard. This is the most standard pistol round right now. And Expert, you know, they're blowing it up. They got some great individual performances, winning the duels, and now they've won the eco relatively cleanly. So they are in a very great position on against what would be considered the much better team.
Indeed so, and we saw some really nice play there by Stig, who is currently on 5 kills and 0 deaths. So Expert Gaming, relatively well at the beginning of this game. But it's early days yet, I can definitely say. And Lemondogs will have to wait until the fourth round here before they can really make a decision. But an interesting little stand, positioning here by the CT side. They're actually going pretty aggressive up mid, seeing if they can get the terrorist side off balance. And Cobra getting a pretty important kill early on in the game there in the underground, and they'll be able to pick up Galil, actually. Zilos picking it up from base. And so now they do know exactly the positioning of the T site. They know they're somewhere in T spawn. They will be going towards bomb site A here. The bomb moving towards that direction. They have lost one man. Aggressive push there by one of the CTs was Delpan. He's not able to do much damage, but it's back to a 4-on-4. At least the CTs have a gun to play with now, and the terrorists will be probably executing towards bomb site A, as that back around towards B wasn't successful enough. CTs are holding on. So far.
And it looks like a relatively simple affair here for Expert now. So definitely good first few rounds from Expert Gaming. I got to point out that there was a nice little play, tactical moves going in from Lemondogs. So they pushed with one player up quite quickly here, and this is a big fear on the anti-eco, is you're worrying about this 5-man or even 4-man push up mid to attack this angle here. So what happened was they saw one man doing that, so that they didn't see the rest of the team, so they can presume that maybe the rest of the team could be there. So they slowed down around this angle, which meant that the guy that was on underpass was just isolated. No, he was completely alone, and that caused a situation where they were able to get a quick frag. But again, they like aggressive play, these Swedes.
And first man down again is base. He's been caught in pretty much exactly the same position, but Zilos will be taken down as revenge, really, for the Norwegian side, who are 3-0 up. We have an AWP on Delpan, and an AWP on Skippy as well. So we expect this in between Spitty here. will be trying to push through apartments towards bomb site B. And that made not too much success. Actually doing quite a bit of damage on HMP. That's 14 HP. Yakin with a support flash that didn't really work as intended, I think. Now, Lemondogs. They see that they're going towards bomb site B. Delpan with the first off shot. Will he get the second? Very nice job there by Delpan protecting the bomb site there from Kitchen. That flick shot not working, but he will get Stig off guard. And this is pretty big from Delpan, who's got himself 3 kills so far. Skippy, the last man standing with the op, is probably going to hit from behind. He'll turn around and Cobra will get the better of. First round here for Lemondogs. And this is looking a lot closer than we had anticipated. And Expert Gaming, the team that we did not really anticipate to be ahead of Lemondogs, is currently ahead, 3-1.
And now we get to peek into the setup that Lemondogs are playing. They're playing an expensive setup. They're going for one AWP so far. Delpan looks like they're going to be going for mid. Some teams have decided to completely give up mid, but they're going for a 2-1-2 kind of setup here, very evenly split across the map. And Delpan even dropping from the pass. Ooh, getting tagged. That was nasty damage. He's in a bit of a nasty position there now. He's got to be careful because he can't expose himself too willy-nilly, else he will just get picked off now that he's so low on health. And but what is his teammate seeing on the B side here? Because we're seeing some action over there.
Has to be very, very careful indeed. HMP got that early kill on Spitty. And a very nice wall bang, but not actually landing any shots. Interestingly enough, it seemed like they might have done a bit of damage. We've seen some dirty kills there, especially by Fnatic. We saw 2 kills yesterday by Devilwalk in that exact position. And wall bang. Nice smack, like smokes and flashes over bombsite B. Zelos had no idea what was going on. And this is a very, very nice bombsite B execute here by the terrorist side. HMP has got himself a very nice angle to get a shot. And you will get a kill on Stig. And it's a 2-1-4 now. The bomb has been planted. They do get the economic advantage, but I think it's going to be pretty much the limit, as Skippy from short will be trying to eye out the bomb. It's pretty much getting defused, and there's nothing he can do about it, as Zevez will take him down with a headshot. Bomb defuse there for Lemondogs. 3-2. Expert Gaming doing a good bombsite B execute, but not able to keep enough of their players alive.
They showed us some great smokes on the site. We could see the smokes kind of blocking off the short player initially, and across Kitchen as well. So that just got them straight onto the plant. Unfortunately, they weren't able to do much more than that, apart from get the entry frag, get the smokes down, and the retake seemed a bit too easy there for Lemondogs. They've been good at retaking B so far, you know, with the help of Delpan and everything. But generally speaking, I like what Expert Gaming were doing there. They're definitely showing some of the CS science going on with those grenades. Let's hope to see more there as they do flood on in with this eco. Stig on actually with an AK, and he's going to be picking up a kill. He actually has the bomb as well, so he might be able to get that down. This could be quite a round now as it goes 2-3, 2 versus 3, and he's going to get gunned down, burned down by the Molotov as well, and that's going to be the end of the round. And a relatively tidy cleanup, but Delpan were a bit too close for comfort there with one health left after that. I mean, would have been a really big deal. I mean, if he had to have rebought that, he would have no cash, and that would be a big difference from 6.7 now, where he can drop or you know, be a much safer. But 3-3 now the score.
Elpan's not been doing so bad. He got 3 kills this round, 3 kills in the round before. I think once he picked up that AWP, he kind of got into his motion. But an aggressive push here by the CTs as they go up mid, and the terrorists have to be very careful. Delpan will get that shot. Very solid AWP play by Delpan here as he takes down Spitty on mid. They do know that there is an AWP at least from Connector. So it's, they have to be very careful. But Base will get a kill on Cobra here on bomb site A, and it's very viable for them to push the site. There's only Delpan here to defend it, and we do have 2 CTs on the other side, and Delpan is really playing big today. Another kill on Base, and he's absolutely destroying them with that off, and he's giving them a huge, huge headache. But Yakin there, stopping the rampaging Swede from committing even more damage. It looks like Expert will be retreating, perhaps. Or are they regrouping to push T-Ramp, which would be a bit of a mistake, as the vast majority of the remaining CTs are...
They're being smart, though. And
pretty much in the bomb site, yeah.
They're waiting just for a bit of a rotation, because them dogs are forced to rotate at least one player. So they've now put it to a 2-on-2. They're making their way in. This is a really nice entry for them. They do get one frag there next to the smoke. Sevis gonna fall, and they do have the bomb site, and it's still a 2-on-2. They are doing a fantastic job. The Norwegians, though, can they pull it off? Bomb planted. Oh, and the cover is there from Yakin. He's gonna save his teammates, even picking up the last kill on Zelos.
Absolutely excellent.
Well executed there. I mean, weight, like that small weight, really shows a lot of understanding, because we saw three players from Lemondogs on this side of the site, and they have to rotate one guy. They have to, because if they could just run back, they had a minute left, they can run back to the other site, and but you've got to have a guy there.
Yeah, you're right. You're 100% right. Stig and Stig and Yakin, you pretty much knew exactly where the CTs were. They went in, they smoked off window, and Stig was able to get that kill relatively easily using the smoke to his advantage. And Yakin gave him the great support that he needed as he planted the bomb, and they pretty much made it like as if they only had one angle to defend at any single time. They never put themselves to attack from more than one angle, and it was a really good use of the remaining smokes and flashes that they had left. So well played by them. Good double nade as well that did a bit of damage earlier on in that round. But here, we're on the eighth round of the game. Expert Gaming, one round up, 4-3. And Zealous will start it off with a kill on Skippy. Spitty returns to the play. As Stig will get a kill here on ladder.
They won't expect the guy on Shadow, I think, as well. In interesting positions from Lemondogs. And even Delpan is holding it down still.
He is being such a pain in the neck today for the T side. He's made a lot of kills and a lot of important kills at that as well. Zebes, they have no idea he's there. And he misses the spray down, but the bomb was still being planted, and he will get the second kill. The third kill will go to, I believe it was HMP.
That's like one of those things. Where it's kind of like the oldest trick in the book thing. You know, you in this position, usually a Shadow, there's only like one guy there usually. Mm. So you kill him. Like, you kill the guy who's on top of the ladder. You don't expect someone to be Shadow. You're like, oh, that's pretty clear. You have so many things to worry about. You know, you tick that off. You check that box. Yeah. There's no one going to be there. And great little move. And having the silenced weapon, that was done, you know, completely intentionally. And here we're going to see the nades going over. Let's see how effective they are. HMP's there, usually the short. Oh, he's actually covering very close, and he's going to get a spray on the couple there, but Yakin has an AK.
Let's see if he can do any damage with that. Tries to plant the bomb, and they get demolished relatively quickly by the rest of the Lemondogs player. Good retake of the bomb site. They're not going to give them any chances. Now, Lemondogs are finally one round up, 5-4 to the Swedish side, and Expert now able to go for a full bite. Stig doing a great job with 12 kills and 5 deaths. He's really keeping his team in the game so far. And on the other hand, we've got a relatively equal distribution of score for the other team. Delpan with 9 kills.
Interesting small set. Messed up the camera a little bit there.
Kind of missed the defense here by Delpan. And that was almost a point-blank AWP shot there by Delpan. It was an interesting little position for him to hold with an AWP as well. Easy round for Lemondogs, 6-4. And the T's are forced onto an eco, and it looks like bombsite A is not really working for them whatsoever. They've been able to defend it almost every single time. And after this eco round, they're going to have to think of something new to do.
Yeah, plucking the smokes a little bit there. I think the standard just delayed push with the smokes and flashes isn't going to work on A. It seems a bit too standard. Lemondogs are really executing very well. All players on their side so far are really hitting their shots. And with Delpan and that AWP support, it's just so... Oh, wow, HMP. That's a beautiful pick there onto Yakin over at the B house. And with that pick, he's going to have spotted some info as well. And now Zealous is getting a pick on mid. Also, Expert Gaming are left with very little options. They're going to feel committed here for the A bomb site, and they're going to go for it. And Cobra's there, chilling still. They're going to drop and find him, but cannot be matched. Oh, there, the P250 will do the work, but Lemondog still hold on. And Delpan survives with this AWP. They're building quite a lot of bank. They can always drop to each other. It's just it's, their economy has been booming the entire time. Mm-hmm. Despite how close it is, their economy's never really been in trouble.
Yep. Delpan with another 3 kills is going to put him up on the top of the leaderboard with 12. And he's showing us that he's got those AWP skills. They're not as rusty as we would presume. And this is, he's at the moment the most dangerous member of the Lemondogs team. Him and HMP have been causing absolute havoc against Expert Gaming. Their combined talent and experience has really, really hurt them. And Expert Gaming have been playing well, but at every single opportunity, they have been shut down by these two players. It's Cobra that will get a very shot on Spitty, and the second on Stig. Stig, for a moment there, looked pretty unaware of what was going on. It's a 2-on-4. It was the terrorist trying to force it into bombsite 8. Yakim, though, with the kill on Cobra. Very nice little crossfire we have here between the two terrorists. And again, we're put in almost the same situation that him and Stig were, or Yakin and Stig were earlier on. But Yakin will go down. It's up to Skippy now with not a lot of HP left. He only finished off there by Delpan. So 8-4 for Lemondogs. They're slowly growing their lead against the Norwegian side, round by round. And on this CT-sided map, it's not unexpected. That's what I'd say. And expert gaming right now, they're just going to have to hope they'll be able to clinch at least 6 or 7 rounds going into the second half. And that'll be pretty good for them. Delpan through the smoke on Skippy.
Oh, wow. You can just see over the boxes on that little boost spot. Very expert AWPing from Delpan. And did he just get dinked by a teammate?
Yes,
he did.
Was a teammate there.
Zevas a bit unaware, really, of what Delpan is doing, getting a bit nuts amid jumping forwards, perhaps a bit unpredictable. But regardless, Lemondogs with a fantastic start to the round with these picks in mid. And it's just Yakin and Stig left. I mean, again, left without much of a choice. They're going to try to combine forces once again on A, it seems. And you can see Stig is just, you know, running across here. And Yakin is trying to work through the house. But they've locked in. They're nowhere to go. Lemondogs are on top of this. Delpan, more specifically.
And the thing is, they need to stop giving so many early kills here to Delpan. They need to stop peeking at mid. They know the AWP is there. They need to stop peeking towards bombsite A. But there is a bombsite that Delpan has not been frequenting so much, and that's bombsite B. And that's probably something expert gaming should be attempting to do, perhaps, is move towards bombsite B and try and execute that early, those smokes and flashes that did earlier on in the game. And I mean, that worked out for them. So, but however, it is going to be a fast push into bombsite A, and Delpan will actually be outside of the action this time. Very, very fast here on the Ikaron. They pick up the M4. Zelos had no idea. Good smokes as well that pretty much split the CT side into three pieces, and great job there by Yakin and Spitty to take down both Cobra and Zevas. Now it's a 4-2 situation with control of the bombsite. It's up to the top two stars of the Lemondogs team, Delpan and HMP, to retake the site. They're both coming in here from connector. They do have the smoke to protect them just for a while longer, but they can be attacked from so many angles. It's very, very difficult for them. Will Delpan go up the stairs and see if he can get a pick over the smokes, or is he just going to wait patiently for his teammate to get into position? HMP coming in here from CT spawn. This is very ballsy play from the CTs, as Delpan will get a kill. So will HMP. Now it's something more realistic. It's a 2-on-2. It's a 2-on-1. 1-on-1 base and Delpan here. Will Delpan finish off the job and get another round for Lemondogs? 10-4. Expert gaming losing in a 4-on-2 situation. Delpan and HMP with an almost flawless push and retake of the bombsite. Great work by them, and great angles as well.
And typically you'd say great eco, but their damage to the economy of Lemondogs is meaningless, and the bonus money that they got from planting the bomb, getting some frags, also meaningless, because it is the last round now. So there's no long-term implication. Mm-hmm. It is just about the round wins at this
point. It was an excellent eco.
It was definitely. But are they going to play into Delpan's palms again? And they will. It's almost too easy. Let's look how many frags he has. 19 and 4 deaths. Delpan is on fire in this match. They are playing into his AWP so much. They keep testing it, and it never ceases to amaze.
He's making those shots every single time. There's really, he is on point today. There's no doubt about that. With that AWP, he's very, very on point. And I think he's going to become one of those players who will figure out exactly how to play the AWP on CSGO. The AWP is one of those weapons that's still 50-50 in the pro scene. HMP with a good angle there, able to take down Spitty. But the terrorists are now going to push into the bomb side. HMP able to get another one. That's good enough for him. Now the rest of his teammates know they're going towards bombsite B. Delpan is going to be smoked off. He's having to change his position, push forward, get that better angle. Actually, he gets the kill on Stig there, even though he didn't have his gun out. Yakin, though, taking down Zevas. And it's all up to Yakin, as he has to fight against both Delpan and Cobra.
I can't believe Delpan got the frags there.
But I have no idea how Delpan was able to stay alive after that. You know, pushing and throwing that. He had his Molotov in his hand. But Delpan, wow, yeah. He's really, really on fire.
To be fair, he had some close calls, but still, 4 deaths is quite impressive. He's AWPing, but still, he did a wonderful job. I'm just surprised we didn't see because obviously they know the smokes, that they were able to pull off these are precision smokes from this spot where you can smoke into the kind of car here and you know, across short. You can get all these like crazy smokes. They know how to do that, but there is a smoke from CT from T spawn into the window. I mean, if they're going to push mid, they should really be trying to smoke out Delpan. But we move into the second half now, and Expert Gaming absolutely need this. They're playing the standards round that Lemondogs also played, the setup. Three men on B to begin with. They're not pushing quite as fast as Lemondogs were, but let's see if Expert Gaming execute just like they did last time, because they had sick pistol aim, sick pistol duels going on, and that's how they did it last time. Can they do this again?
What's going on here? There's a push at the CT spawn. They don't really care so much about defending the bomb site. They're trying to get them all before they push into the site, and this is interesting play here by Lemondogs. It's kind of hurt them as they've lost two men, but very aggressive here. Delpan, him, and Zelos, the last man standing, as he gets a double kill. Will he get the third? Oh. Trying to get knifed there by Skippy. Delpan is completely on fire. Finally shut down by Stig, but a wonderful push into CT spawn, which the CTs did not expect. Really, really hurt them. Really hurt them as they tried to rotate back into the site. And as I was just about to say, you know, Lemondogs were behind Expert Gaming. Expert Gaming after getting the first round. Okay, they're going to get the next three after that. They got the fourth, and it looked relatively 50-50. But now Lemondogs, all of a sudden, are really getting their grooves going. Now they've won the pistol round. They're going to probably win the 2-3 rounds after that.
It's like, you know who is a big fan of, actually Threat, you know, he's a big fan of that kind of play towards CT spawn, but he often says, like, he likes to just, he's like, don't plant the bomb, just all five men, just go to CT spawn, just go through CT spawn, because people give up A very easily. Yeah. It allows you to just get all in CT spawn, and you'll get like a couple frags for free. So he likes, he favors not even putting the bomb down, just in favor of manpower, sheer numbers advantage. And that there's a lot of merit
it's different
to that.
Yeah, it's different. I mean, the CTs don't expect that. They really don't expect that kind of play. They don't expect the terrorists to push through and not plant the bomb. But it's wonderful to see. Cobra. Good job peeking at the right moment. Skippy actually taking down Zelos. If he's able to keep that Galil, it wouldn't be so bad for him. Be relatively successful eco. But Skippy now pulling back all the weight to T-spawn. He is being hunted down furiously. The remaining Lemondogs. 13-4 though for the Swedish side. They're looking very, very confident at the moment. I think they're slowly getting into the groove of things. But I honestly believe it's really up to Delpan. You know, Delpan, only five deaths. The rest of his teammates have had 11. So that's at least six rounds where he is the last man standing, or he is the last man alive.
And
he
now
is the person who's kind of allowed them to survive that round, or allowed them to even win that round. So 13-4. And
this is the only guy who has nades. Skippy is the only one who has nades on CT side. They lose this round, they cannot buy. They lose this round, it's 14-4, and they have no money. It's going to then be 15-4, and they have to find a draw. I mean, it is so bad for Expert Gaming right now. It looks so promising at the start, it really did.
It did. Delpan actually holding a very nice position there. He's boosted up there. CTs did not expect them to be over there. Skippy. Looks like the terrorists are rotating. Put a bit of pressure. They test the waters at bomb site B, and now they'll be backing away towards bomb site A. But the defense for the CT side seems relatively disciplined. They're not wavering. We do have two terrorists coming up through connector. There are two CTs waiting for them. Zelos checking behind, as base will be able to take down Zeb. Zelos is exactly where he is. Pre-aim and pre-fire will get him the kill. Skippy is going to stand strong, and well done by Skippy as he takes down both Delpan and Zelos, and defend the bombsite from the coming terrorists. It's 4-2, and now it looks like Expert Gaming might be able to get their lucky break and get their fifth round, but they have to keep it tight because HMP is still alive, and HMP is a very, very good player. Falling down, getting all taken off. He is coming from every single side. There's nothing he can do. He actually gets a kill before he's taken down. He takes down Stig. However, that's a round for Expert Gaming. The Norwegians are back into it, 13-5. Their economy is surviving. Now they just have to play a very, very, very solid CT side. They can't lose this anti-eco, and they can't lose the subsequent rounds. And we see armor buys here by Zelos and HMP.
Yeah, they cannot falter. They're just, I guess, evening up the money. Let's have a look. Yeah, just more or less evening up the money a bit. And they cannot falter. They cannot put a foot wrong now, Expert Gaming. The Norwegians must bring it home from this point forwards. And we're seeing a mid take from them, from Lemondogs so far with pistols. And this is going to give them a lot to work with. And this is going to go straight in. And Expert Gaming are, in fact, not faltering in this round so far, as we have just three Lemondogs remaining. But they're finally HMP to take down one. There's another in a exposed position, but he's able to do the damage, and it's Zelos left now.
The thing is, it's a very interesting choice by base to hold connector and that angle with an M4, especially when you know your opponents have pistols and armor. Mm. I mean, it's almost 50-50. Like, it's one bullet to the head and yeah, that distance. That so why you want that long range? Why would you stick on connector in that angle? Maybe you don't. Maybe you're thinking, well, my opponents will never think that I'll be taking this angle, so I'm going to take it anyway. So I'll take them by surprise. But they were checking every single angle, and he was able to get the better of one of the opponents, but he lost his M4, and it could have been really disastrous. If you lose your gun early on against the Nico side, it can go either side. But that was another round for Expert Gaming, but this is the real test here, as Lemondogs will be able to buy. Double nade is actually not going to finish off Cobra. Yakin's M4 will instead flash over the stairs here. Expert doing an excellent job of defending the bomb site. Yakin in a very, very annoying position for the terrorist. He's moving all over the place, changing left, right, jumping up and down, looking at different angles, and he's going to get a bit of support here by Spitty. Base as well. They're really trying to force bombsite A, the terrorists. They've thrown down the smokes. Yakin is still in a very annoying position here. And Stig, with two kills on both Zealous and HMP. It's all up to Delpan right now with his AWP. Will Delpan be able to do much against the first kill on Skippy? He's going to hurt them. He's going to make it as painful as possible. That's one thing we know about Delpan. He's not going to go down easy. He has this edging feeling. CT is going to come up from behind, and CTs have to be very careful. Alpan is far too experienced for these kind of games. The bomb is down. He's got 25 seconds left on the clock. And for him, he just wants to save the AWP. For the CTs, it's better if they take him down. But he's just quietly chilling here in the palace. And I think the CTs are a bit afraid of Delpan. They're a bit afraid of his AWP.
They should really try to close in from both sides. And
at the same time, but that's a big mistake here, as Yakin goes in on his own. But Spitty will get the wall bang on Delpan. Not bad there.
Good stuff.
Good stuff here by Expert Gaming. 13-7. They are rekindling hope and a comeback against the Swedish side. And now, again, the terrorists are forced onto an eco.
The funny thing is, it's actually, they still get value money-wise from losing a player there because they pick up the AWP. So actually trading one player for the player down on the AWP is actually quite a big value play for them.
It wasn't too bad, it wasn't too bad.
So that's okay.
It's really important to get the AWP out of Delta. Very fast push here. Onto shot. Good smoke by the terrorist, but there is a little gap that Base can see from as he gets himself the second kill. It wasn't perfect. Zealous will surprise Skippy and push into the bomb site. Picks up the AWP, actually. They have to be very careful here. Sadly, he won't be able to get those no scopes. 13-8, Expert getting three rounds in a row. But Lemondogs now able to afford that AWP on Delpan, and they're able to afford AK-47s for the rest of the crew.
So let's see how Delpan opens up the round here. He could potentially be against Skippy. They both decide to go mid. If I were Expert Gaming, I wouldn't really like to challenge Delpan on mid. He's been on fire with the AWP. Looks like he's going to go for the quick pick here over towards B. This could be really, really nice if there's anyone there. But in fact, actually, lots of pushing coming in onto mid. And that's going to clean up the other half of that little split there from Lemondogs. So this is a really well-timed aggression from the Norwegians. They're really showing that they know what they're doing here. And are they going to be able to actually put in the support?
Wondering what's
going to happen
here. It's 3-on-5.
Nice execution there from HMP, taking down Base, perhaps a little bit too curious for his own good over there at Connector. And that's going to start to even things up quite significantly. And Delpan is still live with this AWP. Aim trained onto the kitchen, slowly moving.
He can do so much
with
that AWP. He can really change the future of this round. What a shot on Stig. Delpan. We've had enough already. Make it fair for Expert. Make this game relatively closer by not being so good. Bomb is planted in bombsite B. The CTs, who are two men ahead, are now two men down as Spitty will get shot down by Delpan. Delpan actually getting four kills that round.
He's a bomb.
I told you. If he's alive, it can go either way. It was 5-on-3, and all of a sudden, it was 3-0.
Okay, I'm just going to leave Delpan cam. Let's go. That's all we need is Delpan cam.
Lemondogs just getting demolished there by Delpan. So back to Delpan cam. Welcome to Delpan cam today. Today we'll be watching Delpan as he completely destroys Expert Gaming. It's going to be an enjoyable experience indeed. The T side.
So a much tighter setup we're seeing here. Not really allowing... I'm not giving any... at all towards mid. They're just going to let Delpan mid. I think that's a smart thing to do.
But he must be rimming with confidence at the moment. I mean, he's single-handedly being the one who's really taken them through and gotten them to 14 rounds. And Expert Gaming, they've played a very strong side. They've played a strong CT side. They're a good side indeed. They've got great players. Skippy, Yakin, and Stig. Even Base and Stig have been doing great. HMP getting that shot on Skippy. Sadly, Zevez from the back. I wonder what happened there. Also was not really checking all the bases by the CT side. Now it's 4-on-3. Stig is actually still on the bomb site. Still holding it, still making sure that they don't plant that bomb. As the rest of the CTs come to rotate, it's 3-on-3, but we do have Cobra still alive. Delphine is down, so it might be actually possible that Expert Gaming will get this round. As Zilos will push in, Stig doing a great job. Cobra picking up that AK-47 on the fly as he pushes into the bomb site. Very interesting play here, and Zilos is the last man standing for Lemondogs. It doesn't seem possible that he will be able to do anything, and he won't. Great job by Stig defend that bomb site, getting those two very, very important kills. 14-9, and hopes are still kindled.
Yeah, it's still doable for sure. We have a bad money situation for Lemondogs, and you know we've seen that the thing that really has been destabilizing Expert Gaming has been the AWP of Delpan. It's been creating so many opportunities for the Swedes.
Kill Delpan. Don't let him pick up the AWP, and you will win.
You will be fine. Nice. Everything will be okay.
Stig.
Skippy's the one with the AWP here for Expert. We see some shots and bases covering for him.
Well, he got their leg shot at least. Yakin's been playing well in this position here. CT side of bombsite A. Oh my goodness. His aim has been on point. It is an eco round. It is an eco mash, but still, you have to agree that that is some really nice aim here by Yakin, who's on 20 kills, actually.
Stig Wow has been locking it down for the most part on B. Yakin has been the man at A. And the thing, Yakin's position is so important because often when they push A, they've been smoking connector and jungle, like this area, very effectively. So Yakin has been left with huge work to do to delay their push for the smokes to run out. And he's been doing that really well. And they're going for the aggression. Expert have been mixing in aggression really, really well. And another little aggressive push from Skippy.
What a shot by Skippy there. Through the wall, onto his head.
Bringing the fight to the
Interestingly, another eco here by Lemondogs. They're taking their time. They're making sure their economy gets very strong before they go for the buy. So they'll be able to go for two buys at least, even if they lose. Wow, double nade here will do a crap load of damage on Lemondogs. But they are down onto the bomb site at least. An eco round by them. a bit of friendly fire there. Spitty going in front of Stig's gun. HMP is now against three men with the help of Stigwell, but Base will finish him off. And this is really interesting, right?
So bad.
Now, Delpan is going to get the AWP, all right? Now, Lemondogs are going to be at their strongest. Delpan, 30 kills and 12 deaths, 14-11. If Expert Gaming are able to win this round and get at the round after that and be and make it 14-13, Lemondogs will have to go on an eco, and it'll be 14-14. This is going to be a very important round here for Expert Gaming. They have to win. Delpan has to go down early on. They have to throw as many smokes as they can, and they have to keep him out of the game. And they have to find out, actually, where is Delpan in the first place? Good smoke here by Delpan on the window. And that's going to force the CT to rotate, change position. And Delpan's checking absolutely every single angle.
They pushed Spitty, pushed all the way through.
Great job by Spitty. They're actually
closing around now. They're wrapping around the Lemondogs team. Yep. So this is really nice. They are mixing in aggression absolutely perfectly so far.
It
hasn't gone wrong for them just yet. And now Expert, they just have to react to the information that they have. They can do that. They can pull it home.
Great nade there on top of HMP's head, and he knew they were there because of the info that Spitty got. Able to finish him off. Spitty will get the headshot coming up from behind, but that's not enough. Yakin able to hold his position. But we do have Delpan still alive here on mid, and I think the best choice for him now is to try and save that off. Really, there is not much he can really do, as Zevez is only on 22 HP. Unless they go rotate and go towards bombsite B, then they can even win this round. But it's going to be a lot. Nice camera there. It's going to be a lot to put on the line. It's really their kind of choice now. Go for the win. They've got 20 seconds left on the clock. Go towards bombsite B.
Ooh, I don't like that angle, especially knowing Delpan's alive. You want to keep this close range.
Stig. Oh, we'll take down Zevez with one shot, and it's him against Delpan in the bombsite. Delpan with the AWP. He's going to be able to finish him off. Delpan doing an excellent job of taking down that first first CT player, but he doesn't have enough time to plant the bomb, but he's going to keep the AWP anyway. So he actually went for it. Oh my goodness. He had one HP as well. He left with the AWP. That must be so infuriating for the T side. He's kept the AWP. So Expert Gaming are going to have to play against pretty much a full buy.
How can it be possible that he is alive? He survives. Like, he's got some protective...
Black magic. It's Delpan's black magic, everybody.
Oh, there we go.
And Base takes down Delpan early on in that round. Palmer. And that's pretty, pretty bad for Lemondogs. He got his revenge.
There is justice in the universe, after all.
He's up to HMP now. Anyway, we just got some quick news that Na'Vi is, in fact, losing towards Flipside on the main DreamHack channel. So that's quite interesting indeed. But Expert Gaming with the comeback today. It's 3-on-5 here. Lemondogs are not looking so good. The next round, they have to eco. So it would be 14-14. It would be pretty much equal both sides. It might be Expert Gaming going through. This is a very scintillating match here today between the Swedes and the Norwegian. And it's Norwegians, and it's quite a bit of a rivalry. As long as we get a kill on Skippy here. Interesting Molotov over at short. HMP taking down base. Lemondogs doing a good job actually with their map control. Yakin though taking down Zealous, and Yakin has been playing very, very solid CS today. Looks like the bomb might be going towards A through connector. Or could it be going towards B? HMP is down. Well, Zevez is between a rock and a hard place here. He doesn't know exactly what to do. Which direction should he take?
And he's fresh meat for Yakin. I'm sure Yakin. Oh, ref, Yakin's a very far back position. Actually, expect him to be a bit further forward, but playing tight to the lines with his teammates.
He almost planted the bomb as well, which has been would have been pretty disastrous for Lemondogs. Are they going to go for the
buy?
They can go.
Them.
They can go for a full buy now, but then it'd put them in a horrible situation on the 15th round. So I don't know. It is going to be an eco. Armor on Zevez to equalize the. We got a deagle on HMP. Let's see the one deagle mid. See if there's anything.
Very well
nice
played.
By Skippy.
Good
great job.
Expert have really been bringing things home here. They've turned it back. They had some very smart aggressions. They never played with any fear. And this is such a key factor that's helping their success there. And we're seeing, get back to Yakin over here. Don't think he managed to make the kill, but he really severely weakened Zealous. You can see he's on no health at all. He's going to run tail between legs. They have nowhere to really work with on this eco. And this is the thing. Expert, this Norwegian team, they're playing without fear. They're keeping it so composed. Their aims has not been faltering. They've not been buckling under the pressure, even in the face of Delpan's AWP, in the face of a much more experienced and legendary, in some senses, lineup, you know, who were Expert Gaming to challenge them. But they haven't faltered. They've been keeping themselves disciplined. And that is remarkable.
That's very important. They've definitely shown that they do have the class, they do have the level, and they do have the teamwork and the individual talent. They look like a team here. They look
they do,
like a very, very good team. They're not making these mistakes. They're playing some good CS, and every single one of these players is really performing up to a very high level. I mean, Base, even though he's made some mistakes, he's on 18 kills. He's doing a great job for his team. So there are no real complaints here. A great comeback as well by them to be, you know, so many rounds behind.
Oh, that's a cool pop flash there. I have not seen that one before off the car. Mm. Always seeing new little grenades. It's nice.
We saw that earlier. I mentioned it. I was like, cool pop flash. And you must have been daydreaming or something.
I was thinking about something else.
Probably thinking of your favorite smokes on Mirage from the T side.
must be. And moving back into this, look how tense this is right now. But look at them and Lemondogs, if I can say their name correctly.
Yeah.
All AKs, they are setting up for this A split here. HMP's got a huge job being that single man going through connector. He's got a really important role. He's got to stay alive. He's got to keep the pressure on from the base. Oh no, he gets based from behind, and now the rush commences. They flood into the bomb site. Such an important round. Lemondogs started off quite well. It's a 3-on-3 now, as Expert are scrambling to try to make the retake, but Yakin, good as ever.
It's all up to him. It's really all up to him. Oh my goodness, what an aid there by Yakin. And now the terrorists look from having the opportunity to win this round to actually losing it. It's all up to Delpan now. He will not actually be able to defend the bomb. And Yakin, again, rising to the occasion. This is the man of the hour. Yakin with that wonderful double kill. Great shot and great nade as well. This true champion of his team has come back 15-14. Thank you for all the 10,000 viewers that we have with us today, or with this match. We really, really appreciate that you are watching this cast, and we hope that you're enjoying it and you're enjoying this very, very close game. But a full buy here from Lemondogs. Are they going to be able to take it to overtime, or are they going to be in a lot of trouble? Delpan with the AWP at mid. And it's all up to Delpan now. He has the AWP. He can do something. He can really cause a lot of havoc. But on the other hand, you have Yakin and Stink, who have been really, really rising to the occasion during this game. This is too close for comfort for both sides. Expert Gaming, though, need one more round, and they're able to go through to the winner's bracket. Lemondogs.
We have all of Norway watching, to be honest. We have Expert Gaming keeping the Norwegian dream alive here. For Norwegian Counter-Strike, they are performing a monumental comeback here against Lemondogs. Delpan, he has that AWP. He was saving that money. Got AK last round. This time, it's serious business. And they are getting a little boost. HMP infiltrating CPL. Can he find anything here? This is very dangerous for Expert Gaming.
Into the window, yeah.
Base is in a very important position. He cannot let Connector go without getting at least a couple frags.
This is a thing I've noticed with Expert Gaming. They've got very static positions. Everybody holding their position. Very disciplined play here. Base has to be able to get the better of Delpan here in Connector. It's all up to this. Delpan will get the kill. Now it's 5-on-4, and it's not looking too good here by Lemondogs. Yakin has to hold his position. He cannot peek. He has to stay back. He has to wait for the terrorist to go into the bombsite, but the bomb is going toward bombsite B. It's going to the weaker bombsite. Delpan is actually marauding. Spitty with a double kill in the bombsite. Zealous taking down Skippy finally, and he gets Spitty as well. It's 2-on-1. Yakin is the last man standing, and Delpan will finish off the job. It's overtime here. Sweden against Norway, and this game could not be closer. Excellent play here by Lemondogs, and
I think,
goodness me,
I think we're actually seeing a big weakness in Connector, actually.
Yes, because that is the weakness of the CT side at the moment.
And when you ever see when you ever see VODS Pro players, they actually are really, really good at defending the Connector because of the way their setups work.
Yep.
Because Connector is actually really, 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 really hard to hold properly, because if it's flashed or smoked appropriately, you're screwed. You can't really fall back effectively.
And it's a tough angle.
In that corner, you're stuck there. The other guy can peek you so well. Like Delpan, he's probably done that 100 times.
Yeah, exactly,
he knows exactly what he's doing.
He outpeaks him. He's faster, especially with the AWP. With the aggressive AWP, he's much faster. And the only thing you can do at Connector is either try and push up or try and smoke and slow them down. It's really tough to just stand there and hold the angle.
You can't do it.
It's very, very difficult. And Base has been losing that Connector pretty much, 50% of the time. However, on the other hand, they were able to go into bombsite B. Even though Spitty got himself a double kill, Zealous, on the other hand, returned the favor. And Yakin coming up, he went from his, kind of strong point where he's been, causing complete havoc against the Lemondogs, against the Swedish side, to a point where he was kind of in between and he was shot by Delpan from behind. So great movement there by Delpan, a great round by Lemondogs as well.
Yep.
And it's been taken to overtime.
Yes, if we actually can go back into the game quickly, I can quickly show a few things from the last round there, because this is actually one of the, quite hard to do well. But we have this obvious this middle take. This is like the clearest thing ever. Everyone they want to take middle, and we're actually getting live into the first overtime. So I'll have to talk about that later. But either way, Lemondogs 15, Expert Gaming 15, Expert Gaming after a crazy comeback managed to tie things up, and we are going into first overtime, and let's see how this fares right now for both teams. Expert, are they sweating? They gotta be sweating.
It's MR3 here. Expert will be starting off on the stronger side as the CTs. They have to win all three of these rounds, I think. They have to win all three of these rounds. Really, they don't want to be in a situation where they're playing on the weaker side and trying to catch up against Lemondogs, who are so, so good, especially HMP and Delpan. They've been playing some very, very tough Counter-Strike indeed. It looks like the bomb is down. It looks like they're trying to see if they can get one or two peaks. They have realized that the problem with the CT side is Connector, and you can see two terrorists are at Connector at the moment. It is Cobra. And I do believe it's Delpan as well. HMP now, here on the underground, will be able to take down Skippy. He does have his crosshair at the right position. That's one man down. Base is actually in a better position than he was before, and he has to peek at the right moment. Switching is gone, but will he get the kill? Goodness me, Zevez. Too close for comfort indeed. It's 5 against 3. Delpan will be shot down, the master of the AWP himself, the Swedish AWP genius, and the 1.6 legend. Great pop flash there by Stig, but he jumps, I think, a bit too early into the crosshairs of the marauding tees. It's all up to Spitty now. Can he hold the bombsite for long enough to get that spot? It's 4-on-2, but they don't have a lot of HP. Nice little flash there as well, but sadly, Zealous hiding behind that wall. doesn't look too great here for Expert Gaming. 16 to 15.
Again, we're seeing problems in the connector, area there. I mean, it was a bit unfortunate. You know, base, he was conflicted about the flash. The thing is that he got pop flashed in there. Like one of his teammates threw a flash in, but he didn't peek when the team was blind.
Yeah.
And then he was gonna throw a flash in, but then he was, you know, that indecision there kind of cost him. Massively.
It kind of hurts him. Yeah. It does.
So we'll see if Expert Gaming can tighten things up. It was a bit of a sloppy round, but Lemondogs starting off this one well with a frag onto Stig. And that should indicate to them that B should be up for grabs because Stig has been the main stopping power over at the B bomb site. Let's see if Lemondogs interpret it the same way. And Cobra going to go for that pick on connector. This time Skippy is going to respond. And that's really good news for Expert. They cannot afford to lose connector and have flanking terrorist players from Lemondogs. As Lemondogs do... It looks like they're working towards the B right now. They've got the bomb on the B house side. And right now from the overview, we can see HMP in this position to try to see if he can spot any CT players who are curious, poking their noses around connector or mid. And it looks like they're going to go for that split. One short and three connector. But HMP's going to try to catch those rotating players. Let's see if he's able to do it. Very low health. This could work out very well for HMP. They're expecting it. But oh, HMP! Can he make even more frags with no health? Absolutely not, surely.
I think Expert Gaming, Lemondogs here have pretty much figured out the flaw Expert Gaming's defense. It's Yakin really holding that position, but they're going to be pushing towards bomb site 8. It's up to Yakin as well. If he's able to kind of stop them from planting the bomb, if he's holding a good position. Delpan with a kill on base. Dear Lord, and Yakin is going to go down. He was the only hope here for Expert Gaming. They're probably going to lose this round. It's Spitty against 3. Maybe 2. Probably not. Zealous takes them down, but they figured out that once they get Yakin out of position, they will, have a much better chance at defeating the CT defense of Expert Gaming. And now it's looking a bit rocky here by the Norwegian side. And we've just heard that Flipside have actually defeated Na'Vi 16-14. So that is a very, very close game indeed. And it's a huge upset as well, as Na'Vi are going to have to be playing in the loser bracket.
Lemondogs just showed us some of the best on-the-fly calling ever.
Oh, Yakin missing that shot there with the scout. And Delpan actually getting it.
Yeah, just scrapping together a buy with whatever they could.
Oh, actually getting some great kills play out there of it. By Spitty. Very, very nice. And Base is in a good position to get himself a third kill. Delos pushing in, forcing this as he takes down Skippy. Will he be able to finish off the job? It's 2-on-3, but not a lot of HP left on the CT side. They can barely add up to 50 or 60 HP. Right now, it's up to Zealous and Delpan with the AWP. Delpan really doesn't need the AWP in this kind of situation. He's probably better off with a pistol. It's one bullet to take them down. He's moving towards bomb site B with that bomb. And Expert are holding some interesting positions here. We have one person in underground. Spitty here going towards kitchen. Stig on short. Actually, not underground, sorry. He's on short, but he'll be taken down by Zealous. And Base now with the M4. Will be going to bombsite B to support his teammates. Will Spitty survive long enough? Will he do enough damage? Oh, and he takes down Delpan. Is he going to pick up the AWP? He's going to come out from the other side. It's 2-on-1. It's not looking very good for Lemondogs. Are they going to lose this third round of this MR3? Yes, they are. It's 17 to 16. At least they got that round, Expert Gaming. And that's good news for them because now they have to get 2 rounds to draw or 3 to win.
One round I need to highlight is that Lemondogs has some of the best on-the-fly calling ever in this round where they had it was a kind of a 4-on-4 situation. They had HMP here and they kind of predicted that there was gonna be a B push. So they kind of had a bunch of players around this area, and so what happened was they pushed around here, the CTs, and they realized, oh, HMP's in that spot, that telegraphs the B push. But then Lemondogs realized that instantly and just rushed through underpass, realizing that all of the CT side of Expert Gaming were out of position.
Yep.
And they just went and hit A. That's such smart on-the-fly calling and such a smart, fast reaction from all the players. It's just phenomenal.
There's some very good CS here played by the Scandinavians, that is for sure. The heart of Counter-Strike in Europe and perhaps the world. And we can definitely see why, as Expert Gaming and Lemondogs are playing some good CS. Nice little Molotov, that's going to definitely slow Expert Gaming down, pushing into the bombsite. We do have Delpan here on window. Base pushing through bombsite B will be able to take down the advancing Zealous. Zevez returns the favor with a kill on Spitty. Lemondogs now still holding their positions relatively well. And Delpan's been playing pretty free form. He's pretty much using his AWP in almost every possible angle. And that's really bad for Expert. They can never really know where the AWP is. And you have to know where the AWP is, so you know where the where to put the smokes and where to push. Is that smoke by Stig going to be useful? Delpan and Zevers getting a kill each. It's 2-on-4. It's not looking too good. Stig, wow, makes it 3. It makes it 2 as Skippy helps him with another kill. It's 2-on-2, and they're going to push towards bombsite B. It might be a mistake as Delpan is there with the AWP. Actually, it's HMP with an M4, sorry. And suddenly, they're deciding to go back. It's a bit of back and forth here by the two sides, and it's a bit of a trick as HMP has gone all the way to the bombsite, but Delpan is waiting for them in CT spawn. He throws the flash, he knows there's somebody there, and it's up to Delpan and HMP to push into the bombsite. Interesting positioning here by the terrorists, and they're both holding the same position, but we do have a crossfire set up by Lemondogs. Delpan jumping up on top. He does see the terrorist. He sees him. He has to stay. He cannot peek. He knows that Delpan's on him. And Stig is going to get the kill on HMP. It doesn't look very probable that Delpan will get this round. As Expert Gaming win the first round of the second half, making it a 17 to 17. Goodness me, I'm too excited. But at the same time, Delpan keeps that up. What do you have to say, though?
It is a really nice push there. And I loved the confusing play. The thing about that is that it looked really bad. It looked like 4 versus 2. But just as that happened, they smoked off this area completely. And just before the smoke went down, there was this great angle from this kind of pocket position here. It's through there, and he tapped him down. So then it was like 2-on-3. And then they got the player on connection in a 2-on-1.
Yep.
And so it actually, despite the on the scoreboard, we saw, okay, 4 versus 2. The way they were isolating players together as a team there really made a great deal. And I love the little move where they looked like there was going to be, and then they jumped through the balcony, made their way back. Very confusing stuff. They forced Lemondogs to move.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Then they always get their 2-on-1s in the plant. It's so smart. Expert are showing very, very good class here. And they are making their way up mid a little bit, getting the pressure on. The bomb is down in T-spawn, so that's a bit indicative of they're playing on the fly here. Zelos in a great position, and almost freezing the game with his awesomeness, as it's just Yakin and Stig who remain, who have been, you know, amazing. They've been the top two fraggers for Expert Gaming on the CT side, but
they're
I don't think
getting
they've got enough to
completely demolished this half, or this round, sorry, as Lemondogs playing very, very confidently, barely losing any HP. Will be able to get the better of Expert Gaming. It's match point for Lemondogs. Yeah, Expert Gaming did not want to be put in this situation. They're going to have to buy up and use all the money they have, and they're going to have to win this round to make it 18-18, or else they're going to be in a lot of trouble. They have to push it on to the next overtime.
And last round was a pick round for them. They were like, okay, let's go for picks. Now they're like, okay, we don't want to go for picks. We're going to go for the hardcore push. They know smokes.
Wow. This is very aggressive here by Expert Gaming. Very ballsy play indeed. Yakin leading the charge for the Norwegian side. Will he be able to get the pick? No, he won't. Zebes coming up from mid here, as Skippy, in fact, will take down Zebes. Smoke will be thrown by Spitty here, trying to smoke off Kitchen. Stop the visibility of the CTs. A lot of nades being thrown here by Delpan. He's got his AWP in the only possible view. We do have two AWPs actually here by HMP and Delpan, as Zelos will take down base hits. 3-on-4. There's not a lot of time left on the clock. It looks like the bomb's going to explode any moment now. They have to hold on for longer. It's Skippy now with the AWP. Can he do this? He's 1-on-3. He's got his Deagle. He takes down one person, and the bomb is going to get defused. It looks like it's going to be a win for Lemondogs, 19-17, and the Swedes clinch it at overtime. Very, very nicely done by Lemondogs, and for a moment there it looked like there might have been an absolutely amazing comeback here, and an upset indeed by Expert Gaming.
Yeah, we got shown a really, really good CS from both teams. I think Expert Gaming, they really impressed me. They did a lot of really nice stuff on both the CT and the T sides, and I actually feel like, you know, it went to overtime. Both teams were just really close. Lemondogs were just able to show a bit more class just in the short amount of rounds that decided the end of the game. But I think Expert Gaming showed in the entire way that, look, they don't get phased. And that's usually a quality of experienced teams. Teams with lots of experience that they can say, okay, you know, we've been in bad spots. We know we can pull through. They showed that kind of caliber. So this is a team to look out for in the future. I hope to see more of them as well. It's a shame that they didn't make it happen, but today I was impressed, and I'm sure they've won
indeed
some fans.
Indeed so. I think Expert Gaming played very admirably indeed. And one thing I told you was that on the overtime, they had to win at least 3 rounds on the CT side, simply because of this fact. They were very strong on the CT. They weren't strong on the T. They only got 4 rounds playing as a terrorist side. So it was easily their weaker side. They got the other 11 rounds on the CT.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So
yeah.
They were a much stronger CT side. They were much better on the CT, so they had to win those three rounds. And they lost two, but got one at least. And it didn't seem so probable. Lemondogs did the job they had to do. They were able to defeat the Expert Gaming, who played very admirably. Yakin did had a great game today there on Bombsite A, and Stig as well, all over the map doing some great kills. And in fact, every single one of their players was absolutely amazing.
Yeah, they showed that they can play really, really good CS. And if they were to go back and look at the demos, they'd be thinking, okay, we can tweak this, we can tweak this. It's not like, you know, oh, damn, you know, we need to make some systematic changes. They don't have to change that much. They're pretty much there. They just need to tweak a little bit. Yeah. And because they even showed some of the hardest things to do, and they did it well, was putting in aggressions well-timed erratically. Yeah. That's the whole point about aggression. Yep. As a CT side, it's got to be unexpected on a map like Definitely. Mirage. And they did it well.
Now, the loser bracket is going to be a very interesting game. It's Na'Vi against Expert Gaming. Na'Vi losing against Flipside, 16-14. This is going to be a very, very interesting game. Will Expert be able to win that game and give themselves a chance to go through the group stages, or is Na'Vi going to go through? Will Na'Vi actually be kicked out? Well, it was a very close game against Flipside. We don't know how good Flipside is. Maybe they're a team of a really high caliber, and Na'Vi will be able to do really well against Expert Gaming. But we'll wait and see. It's definitely something that is that'll be very interesting to watch. The next match with us is most likely, and I'm pretty sure, is going to be Na'Vi versus Expert Gaming. So do stay with us. It is going to be a very, very interesting match indeed. On the other hand, Flipside versus Lemondogs on the main DreamHack channel. So if you do want to watch that match, you can go and check it out there. But obviously, why would you leave the most handsome stream on Twitch at the moment? There's no reason to do that.
I'm getting emotionally invested in Expert Gaming after seeing such great CS from them. I just want to see more of this team, because we see, you know, a lot from some of the more household names.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
This team is something new, something fresh. I want to see more of them. I'm excited. I hope you guys are as well.
Definitely. And I think I can feel the excitement going through from the interwebs. I can feel it.
The internet, the electronic cat
interwebs,
database.
Not internet, interwebs.
All right, so we'll be having a quick break after this. Lots of excitement. We'll see you soon.